Good bloody morning, people. I've just been rearranging my collection of snakes. They've been sitting in a cupboard and, well, I thought I'd put them out on display. See, I've got my skulls on display here. Where's the first one? Bloody sun's a bit strong. So this is a wombat that someone ran over just down the road. I let him rot away and I'll put his skull there. This one's some sort of dinosaur. This one's one of them black cockatoos. He died by the creek of old age. Here's a saber-toothed tiger. Picked that up at a market. And now the snakes. So here, in this first jar, you can see their heads. One, two. There's two bloody red-bellied black snakes, or sometimes they're called a copperhead, and they're deadly. And those two buggers, this one and this one, they were raiding the hen house, and they were taking the little chicks. And when they were attacking and taking the little chicks, me and the dogs bloody come up, and we smashed the crap out of them with a fencing sword. One in the coop, one under the drawbridge as it tried to escape. Bastards. Now this one. This is a bloody tiger snake, you can see by the stripes. Now that bugger, I wonder if we can see just his tail to confirm who he is. Oh, no, I don't think he's the one that... Hang on. If the tip of his tail is missing, he's the one that tried to kill me. But it's all curled bloody under. But anyway, one day, I was doing some concreting, pouring concrete into one of these walls, just like this bloody wall, but it wasn't this wall, but it was one similar. Here's Belka. Hello, Belka. She's helped me kill these snakes. This one in particular. This bugger. Now, back to the story of him. I hope I've been aiming this camera well. Look, there's those first two evil buggers. The red-bellied black snakes. Their bellies were bright red, but they've faded in the metho. Now this bugger. So, I saw a snake crawl down inside the wall. And so I filled it in, I waited a while, mixed up some concrete and poured it down the hole. And then it was in bloody February. And it was 9 o'clock, or about 9:15 or something like that at night. I was supposed to call my cousin at 9 and I called her a little bit late and she didn't answer and I sat down in front of the fire and this bastard, have you ever heard a bloody snake cough or bark? He was there hissing and barking at me like that. And I looked up and he was in the rafters and he struck at me. He tried to bloody kill me because I'd filled in his hole. Maybe his mate was under there. But he came at me, and I grabbed the sword. It was a big, chunky, theatrical thing. It was the only thing I had, well, it was the closest thing I had at hand. I've always got swords all bloody around me. And as he struck out of the rafters, I parry him away with my blade, but the sword was too slow, and the snake was too quick, and every time I went to riposte, as in parry riposte, the hit after you defend yourself with a blade, a parry is a defense with a blade, if you didn't know, and he'd get back. And I chopped just the end of his tail off, and he came down out of the rafters, went under the bed. And Belka was with me. Belka was barking and barking, and it was dark. And this bloody snake, he was under the bed and just striking out at me, or at Belka. And I changed my swords. I got a light, sharp little short sword. And I put on some big, long welding gloves, go up to me, past me elbows. And he was under the bed, and there were all these crates under there, or baskets. And I had to pull them out one by one, and he'd strike at me, and Belka would bark and dart at him, and then he'd go for Belka, and then... So she saved my life numerous times from this bloody tiger snake. And eventually, I got all of the stuff out from under the bed, and he crawled behind this rock, because the wall has a rock foundation, and he wouldn't come out. And while we left the room, and he still wouldn't come out of there, so I banged on the rock from the other side. Belka ran in, and he was coming across the floor, and I smacked him on the middle of his back, broke his back. That's the way you get them, right? Go for their head, they move their head. Go for their tail, they can move the tail. Right in the center, bang, because that's their where they swivel. And so you smack them, break their back, then their tail's not moving, and then you can hit them in the head. And watch out, they can kill you when they're dead. I don't know if it's all over the world, but when you kill these snakes around here, they wriggle until the sun goes down, because they're cold-blooded. And they'll still bloody bite you. Now in here, well, this is another tiger snake. Not as big or as aggressive as that one. I don't actually remember how I killed this one. I think I, either this one, or this one, or this one. So one of these three I shot with my bow. There was this big pile of rocks that I was going to make a wall out of, and a big snake was in there, and the dogs were all barking around it, and so it stayed there for a few days. Gave it a chance to get away, and it didn't, so I sat there and I waited. And when he came out, I shot him with an arrow, and I stuck him to the ground. Not too far from his neck. Stuck him to the ground, and then I think I probably finished him off with a fencing sword. One of these was just lying on the fencing piece one day, and then it died by a fencing sword. And the other one, I've at least got one with a fishing spear. So one of these, I reckon, is a fishing spear. Now, this little darling, I was chopping some wood, and out it popped, and it was already gone, the poor bugger. So he's in the jar. Now I've got to top up some of these jars, especially this bugger, because this is the one that tried to kill me, and I want to keep him on display. Because you try to kill me, I'll bloody kill you. Okay, that's me snakes. Bloody, 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 bloody.